Today, you're going to learn why disabling the root login over SSH is a good idea. Stay tuned. My name is Trevor. This is NerdLearn. Let's get started. So what are we fixing? We are fixing a huge security vulnerability by denying root login over SSH. Because if this account is ever compromised, an attacker, they can do anything. They own the box. So we're going to use a second administrator account, and this is going to force our attacker to put a little effort into this. So they're going to have to guess the actual name of a second account. And then once they got that, they need to crack that password. And then they still want root, so now they have to crack a second password. And then another benefit of this is we're going to force all administrators to log in as themselves so we can record their actual login IDs. And just in case any of our administrators get compromised or maybe we have an insider threat, we can disable the one account. Even if that individual knows the root password, they can't do anything with it because their account is disabled. So how do we make all this happen? Let's get going. First, we have to log into our server. So I'm going to log in as root. Basically SSH space root at and then IP address or a host name. This is asking me for the root password on the remote server. And I say, who am I? And I can see that I am root. So it's really important that we have a second administrator account besides root to get into this system. So we're going to make a new user. I'm going to make my second administrator Alice. And so I'm going to type adduser Alice. We're going to give Alice a new password with passwd Alice. And then we're going to confirm our password. I want to make Alice an administrator. So I'm going to use the command usermod dash A capital G wheel Alice. If we were on a Debian based, we would instead have chosen sudo. Now we want to SSH as Alice, so I'm going to open a new terminal window here. And we're going to use the command SSH space Alice at our IP address. Enter Alice's password. So we've confirmed that Alice can get in. She does have the correct SSH permission because she's part of the wheel security group. Now that we know that we have another administrator that can access the system, we can safely disable the root login. So for this, out of habit, I'm used to typing sudo, but there I go again, but whatever. Using sudo depends on whether you're root or not. But we're going to do sudo nano slash etsy slash ssh slash sshd underscore config. Now we're looking for the line that says permit root login. And right here. So we change this line here from a yes to a no. We're going to hit control X. We're going to hit Y and we're going to hit enter. And that allows us to exit, save our changes, and overwrite the existing file. By restarting the SSH service, the changes in the file are going to get used. Type systemctl space restart space sshd. And now we verify that we can get our users back in. So I'm going to start with Alice here, because she should not be affected. And there she is not. And now I'm going to log in as root. So notice how the left window is still logged in as root. So the fact that we have disabled the service, we modified, we denied the permission, and we restarted the service to use the new deny permission, the existing terminal is still logged in. All right, attempt number one on the password for root. So what we see here is a permission denied, and this is showing that root cannot get logged in on new SSH connections. I'm going to use the root password two more times just to make sure. So we can see that root is no longer authorized. Now, if we exit out of this window, we've now killed the root session, and we up arrow back into the root. As expected, it's denied. In future videos, I'm going to be showing you how to secure your servers, as well as giving you some additional refinement on your SSH and your sudo commands. If you found value out of this, please smash that like button and subscribe and stay tuned for future videos.